So look, here's the thing. Last week I did an episode, and what we're talking about is social media negatively impacting athletes out there, right? Is social media negative? And then some people said some people said yes, it's negative. Some people said it's not anything. Anyway, so this week what we're going to dive in and talk about. So a gentleman reached out and was like, John, you didn't really talk about connecting. You didn't talk about the importance of relationships, and you didn't talk about the value of connecting. So first I was like, well, is he just telling me this because he's trying to connect with me? Because he was like, I'd love to talk to you more about it. And I was like, oh, you're just trying to get on the episode. Yeah, that's what you're trying to do. But anyway, enough about that. What I want to say now is today, in today's episode, I'm going to break down what can connecting look like for you as an athlete, right? How can you connect with people around you and learn to leverage the position that you're currently in? Without further ado, let's go and get into this week's episode.
Welcome to the On the Ball Podcast.
So look. Okay. So like I said before, this is what we're focusing on today. But if this is your first time, right? It's your first time tapping in, first time tuning in. This is Beyond the Ball, and I'm Jonathan Jones. And what we do on our platform here is we desire to help student athletes ultimately successfully transition from college to career, right? So this is just not giving them just some strategies or some thoughts or some philosophies. We're giving tried and true life lessons. We're giving the game on experience, and I'm sharing what I've learned so that ultimately you can be helped, you can grow, and you can be able to really kill it in the next phase of your life, whatever that might be. If that's you going pro, great. If that's you becoming a corporate professional, even better. You know what I'm saying? So without further ado, what I want to share with you all today is just 3 points, right? Because I had the opportunity to talk with a gentleman this past week. His name is Mike Miller. Okay, shout out to Mike. And Mike is doing great things up in Indiana. And I was talking with him because he was doing like a tour, going to these different colleges in different states and learning how they're incorporating their student athlete development. I was like, that's pretty dope. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty dope that Mike got that going on and has that time, you know, to be able to travel and learn from other people to see how he can implement that into his program at his school, at his institution, which is NAIA. But he was going to Division I programs, and we had the opportunity to further talk and further chat. And the reason why I want to share that is because this all came by way of a connection from LinkedIn. You hear me? And mind you, this doesn't necessarily have to be LinkedIn specific. This could be Instagram. This could be Twitter. This could be whatever social media that you deem or that you see as valuable and one that you actually engage on, right? So the reason why I want to share that is because the first point I have for you all today is this. We can't truly go deep in relationship with people if we never take the time to connect with people. I'm going to say it one more time. We can't go deep in relationship with people if we never take the time to connect with people. John, what are you saying? What are we talking about? Connect with people. Like, what are you talking about? Like, connect as friends on LinkedIn or connect as followers or like, what do you mean? When I say connect, yes, the initial part of connecting is sending a request, sending a message, reaching out to that person. What could it look like? A message could say, hi, such and such. I see that you have great content on blank. Right. And this could be something that you have an interest in or something that just stood out in their profile. And you can say, I see that great content on blank. I would love to know more about this content. And I would even love to hear more about your journey, more about how you got to this point. I would love just to learn more from you. Send. Allow them the opportunity to respond. Might be a couple of days. Some people might be a couple of weeks, but you don't just want to wait on one person. You can send multiple messages. You see what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah. And then the thing that you want to do is after you connect, right? And then they respond and then you have the opportunity to really talk to them, get to know more about them. I want to encourage you on this. be genuinely curious about the person you're talking to. Interview them, okay? Like, really take time and learn more about these people. And the reason why you want to do that is because the more you learn about people, then the better ways you'll be able to identify how you can help them. If you let somebody talk long enough, they're going to tell you what a struggle is. They're going to tell you what a challenge is. They're going to reveal to you the secret sauce that if you give them, then you will be able to help them out. You know what I'm saying? So look, this is, we want to make sure that we connect with people, right? My dad says you got to connect before you collect, but we're not even at the collect part at all, unless we're just collecting information about who they are, about their story, about their journey and everything along the lines of that. But I really want you to get that piece, connect with people that you find interesting. Connect with people that you legitimately would want to learn more about, right? And then as you connect with these people, you're going to start to realize you begin to build some dope relationships with some individuals throughout the country. Over the past years, I've been able to develop some amazing relationships with some different individuals all across the country. A gentleman by the name of Aaron Tillman, that's my guy, that's my bro. Me and him connected, I'm not sure how many years ago. But he's down in Florida State. We got to link up in person. Been connected ever since. Me and my guy, Ed Jones, I tease him all the time. Because when I hopped on a call with him, I was like, bro, you seem like you did not want to be on the call. And you was not giving me nothing. Like, no engagement, nothing. But now me and him still connected. He's actually a member of my podcast mentorship group. So shout out to him. You know what I'm saying? So him, like I said, Aaron Tillman. Man, I can just go down the line. Dr. Paige Diggs up in West Virginia. Tangela Cheatham. Man, there's many, 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 many people I can just go down the lines. Danny B. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, so we want to connect with people and we want to be legitimately interested in them, in their story, in their journey. So now when we ask questions, we really care what the responses are. You hear me? You really care what they're going to say. Okay, y'all got that. Y'all got that. So look. So after you do that, then the natural next step, see how you can help them. Wait, John, but what about me? No. It's not about you right now. Mm-mm. It's not about you yet. It's not about you yet. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. It's not about you yet. After you talk with them, and you learn about them and you hear them share what their struggle is, or some might not even directly say it or might not even let it slip out. But when you ask somebody, well, you know, it was great talking to you, Mike. It was great talking to you, Rhonda. It was great talking to you, Brenda. Can I ask you one question before I let you go? Oh, sure. What is it? How can I help you? I don't know, John. I might have to get back with you. Well, yeah, get back with me. Because I want to know how I can help you. Some people might sit there on the phone for a second. And they might think about it. Others already know how you can help them. They may just not come directly out and say it. But either way, once you connect with somebody, your first thought should not be, how can you take something from them? It should be the opposite. It should be, how can you give something to them? How can you add something to their life, to their situation, to where they are, period. And then when you do that, like I said, then you ask, okay, how can I help you? How can I help you? Because the majority of people meet individuals and they see them as a number. They see them as a number. See them as a number. Look, it's real sad. Look, see them as a number. You don't want to see people as a number. Why do you not want to see people as a number? Because if they realize that you only see them as a number, as a thing, as how can I use this person to get what I want, it's going to be very transactional. It's going to be very, very, very short-lived. But if you see how can you learn more about them and then add to their life, they're going to keep you around. And then they're going to refer you and they're going to refer you if you do point three that I'm about to share right here. They're going to refer you if, and this is the third and final point I got for you, you go the extra mile. You go the extra mile. Ask them, can you connect them with somebody that you know? Ask them if they're building out a program, how can you be a part to just add some advice or add some insight and just share your experience? If you know that they're new at this particular job, this particular role, see if you can connect them with somebody who potentially could be a mentor for them. At the end of the day, no, none of us make it out this life alive, okay? So why would you not want to plant the most seeds possible to help somebody else be successful in the field? Come on, man. Come on. We got to stop trying to be selfish and try to make sure, oh, I got to get what I want. Oh, what about me? Oh, what about this? You'll get what's yours in due time when you do this foundational work. And the foundational work looks like taking time to get to know people, putting your selfish needs to the side, serving them at a very high level, and then you serve them so well. You help them so much. You add so much value. They're to the point to where what they call the law of reciprocity, where you've helped somebody so much to where they ask you, well, what can I do for you? And you say, no, I'm good. No, no, they're like, no. What can I do for you? You've done this. You've done that. You've helped me do this. You helped me with that. You talked to me about this. What can I do for you? I feel like I owe you something. People will always feel like they owe you something if you've given something to them with no strings attached. But if you give them something with strings attached and they know that you gave them something with strings attached, they gonna wait and just see how long you stick around until you just fade off, just like everybody else that tried to get something from them. Man, if this is making sense, if this is helping anybody, drop something down in the comments on YouTube if that's where you're watching. Man, be sure to like and comment on YouTube if you're tapping in. I need to know who appreciates this content and if it added any value to your life, right? If it added any value to your life, especially my student athletes. Man, my student athletes, let me know. Let me know what topic I can cover for you that'll be beneficial for you that I haven't talked about just yet. Let me know what topic would help you right now in your journey, in your transition. All right. So one more time, let me just recap those points. So look, I said, first, we got to connect with people and be curious about them. So that's C squared, connect and curiosity. All right. So connect with people and be curious about them. You're not the focal point right now. They are. Number two, see how you can help them. How can I help you? How can I help you? Are you sure you don't need nothing? How can I help you? Like, what do you need help with right now? Are you good right now? All right, I'm going to tap in with you next week. How can I help you? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And then when they tell you how you can help them, go the extra mile. Don't be stingy in your giving. Nobody likes a stingy giver. Nobody likes a stingy. God don't even like a stingy giver. And the Bible says God blesses a cheerful giver. So understanding that, yes, we should be cheerful when we give to God, but if we're created in his image, when we give to other people, we should give cheerfully as well. Can I get an amen? Amen. All right now. Hey, all right now. So look, we're going to wrap this episode, but before we do, this is the final segment. It's been a while since I've done it, so I wanted to tap back in and do it and start showing love and shouting out to those people who are really killing it out here and really putting in work, like really, really putting in work. So I want to shout out this young lady. I found her on Instagram a couple of days ago because she was doing what she does. And what she does is she does like a little bit of commentary type deal, traditional reporting, and she even does some hot takes. I saw her Instagram and then also double back on her TikTok as well. And she has a contract with FanDuel, right? So she puts out some sports betting related content and even DAZN. For the NFL. I'm not sure if it's DAZN or DAZN for the NFL. That's why I just spelt it. But y'all, without further ado, the winner's circle of the week this week goes to Miss Bailey Jackson. Yeah. Shout out to Miss Bailey Jackson. Bailey Jackson Sports on IG. All right. Bailey Jackson Sports on IG. Just wanted to shout her out because she's putting out some dope content. some hard-hitting content, just like you said, some hot takes. And it's dope to see when she puts it out, because I'm like, oh, man, I can appreciate the way she put it out, right? And even as she's branding herself and just continuing to, you know, just make her way in this field, in this space, shout out to Bailey Jackson. And y'all, without further ado, we're going to go ahead and end this episode. Like I said before, if this episode was beneficial to you, please, please, please let us know in the comments. And feel free to rate us, you know, if you're on Spotify, Apple, just give us a rate, you know, let us know what you think and everything like that. But family, until next time, this is a Beyond the Ball Media production, and I'm Jonathan Jones, and this is Beyond the Ball, where we help student athletes succeed beyond their degree.